as you can see, the hard pressure is another open source. But this is only for the private blockchain, which is built by IBM, and part of R3 and everything else. Huawei, we are Flutterpay. So, right, two more questions. Anyone know trade finance and banking world? Yep, one. Even less viewers. Okay. What about supply chain? Okay, one. Okay, I'm talking to explaining about supply chain right now and trade finance. Next slide, please. So, in trade, look at, just imagine you want to buy something from Taobao and maybe some e-commerce website and everything. I have to stand on one side. If you can see over here, trust and trade, because there is always, if you put your money somewhere, who do you trust? Can someone tell me? Yeah, the banks, right? And if I want to buy containers and everything, so usually I go and get letter credits. So the letter credits can be fraud, you know, can be Photoshop and stuff like this, and put in not in digital format. So blockchains helps because it just can never be tampered through, never be returned and stuff like that. So next slide, I'm going to show you something else. Next slide. Next slide. Okay, as you can see, a little bit history. So it's a bit boring, but as you can see in the graph over here, back in the 15 BC, is that people on trade is on ship, you know, leather ships and before, all right, half a year or something. And then people sail, and then they come to Venice. Yeah, 16th century. Okay, fast forward. And then it goes to like merchant Venice. After that, okay, 90s. I was born in 90s, 80s. Oh shit, you guys know my name. Okay. And telecommunication. I want to point this telecommunication. I've been through this era, and from a telephone line all the way up to, remember back in the days, the telephone line? Yes. And you can connect it in there, and after that, you go to broadband, and now you go fiber and everything. So, and now, nowadays, you use a phone. Alright, today, blockchain. Yeah. I hope this is not a tech talk, so I'm down here, but blockchain is a digital language. So, this is a private blockchain I'm using. And next slide, please. I'm going to show you a little video, but there's no sound. So, let's play the video. Right, this is talking about the someone ordered 5 flowers, and there's a flower that goes to the market, and they can connect the computer and they have sensors, LPS, and also the box has GPS as well. So with blockchain, you don't need to set up a centralized infrastructure. Like us, I use AWS. This is also cloud, this is also centralized. So, what benefits using the supply chain of blockchain? So, the carrier A's and carrier B's go through the journey and stuff like this. You've got a processor, warehouse, groceries, and the stuff are IoT enabled. And you can check the pictures of every single container. Every single section. And this is the flower that goes to the grocery store. And the carrier 1 and carrier 2 will go through this thing cross line contracts, which is basically the and then you have this, you have all the information shared. So you can have all the authorization, what shared, what's not shared. And you have left because of the
things of the heart.
Left? No. Everyone fall asleep? Yeah. Okay, let's start. Right. Let's go back. So what's the problem here? The problem in trade that is contrast easily controlled. And next slide is those. Yeah. You know, on the back in our days we used to use bank, wire transfer, and sometimes PO invoices. I think you guys deal with it quite often that it gets delayed payments and getting letter credits. Anyone get tried on the job getting letter credits? No, I think this is a huge big point. Every single documents are manually processed. And lack of compliance, and an employee can easily temper the thing. And if the employee leaves the thing, if I take a Photoshop of that letter credits and just go and say bye bye the company, I can use that and reuse that letter credits to do some other funky business. Correct. So next slide, please. So this is TechCrunch. TechCrunch says this. So what sorts are different? We look at this modern supply chain thing, and we can bring through visibility and trust because this is blockchain anyway, and it's distributed. You can just secure and tamper-proof and all the hash and everything. Well, hopefully, fingers crossed, all the ports and all the banks and insurance will add it additional value to the business. Because our PSA and Port Authority is coming up on smart port program. They have a launch in the US. And also transparency, consent, I don't expect that because it helps to clear the sentiment to the smart contract. Yeah, next slide. Thank you. Right. This is the main thing when it comes. You look at this here. You know, A buyer, B buyer want to go buy something, and then this is a traditional model. They get the letter credits and stuff like this. And why blockchain? Because transparency and digital users and everything. So I don't need to see the slides, but I just want to talk to you about that. So I want to talk about the blockchain model. Blockchain model this year is quite amazing because documents are encrypted, it's tamper proof. And also, at the same time, the letter credits becomes replaced by smart contracts. And also, the letter credits, sometimes we go through a transition period. Sometimes corporations, they still insist on letter credits. So I think, okay, fine, we just put it on, scan the PDF and then put it on hash and make sure it doesn't reduce again. So, next slide. Yeah. We are now. Yeah. Okay. We reach out to small businesses because IBM is doing the same thing as me, but we don't just go and join the same partnerships and everything. And also, we try to partnership with small little startups. I'm an entrepreneur myself. We believe in helping other entrepreneurs, startup blockchain startups and entrepreneurs, because as you can see, blockchain adoption rate in B2B is quite funny because the adoption for B2B business is usually 6 to 8 months if you're lucky. If you're unlucky, you survive 18 months to 24 months to get one customer. And you talk to the banks, they say, oh, we're doing blockchain, we're doing blockchain company business. I was like, oh, no, we don't want you. It's like blockchain, stay away, because you're taking their revenue streams, right? And we're trying to expand in Singapore. We have in Hong Kong, we are validated in Hong Kong, and we try to experiment that model. We try to embrace that factories models and getting them on board and make sure that sometimes the factories are very, very funky because they can just make a Photoshop for the documents and they say they want a loan for the banks. And then they want a loan for the banks and then factory of thinking. So once you got the money, bye bye. There's a lot of Chinese, there's a lot of China factories. When I was reading Marx and Cancer, I was talking to the finance department and tons of factory makers. Okay, next slide please. Ah, where are we? Okay, this is the whole chart of the blockchain in the global scale. I'd like to thank to Autonomous because they are doing amazing things in Singapore. And then there's not coming as new chain. They are within the US. If you'd like to share the slides, I can give you the slides here. And this is our space. There's the smart contracts. And I'm very sorry I forgot to put Taurus in, but I'll do that. And also, the governments, internet of things, and blah, 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 and so on. So, next slide, please. Next slide, please. Thanks. So, I'm very fortunate. I'll say I'm very fortunate that I'll thank to Asian Pacific that I'm speaking here. Thanks to Asian Pacific to give me a chance to speak here. Otherwise, I don't want to. And also, we have been interviewed by NVIDIA, and we are trying to close, we're doing close production with SME right now. And we are big plus members, Marks and Spencer and Hip Hop. We are looking for Angel Round. We just opened up Angel Round, and we're looking for mentors and willing to believe in blockchain. And it's very hard to find investors in that space because this is the next big thing. It's not a hype, but it's the next big thing in 5 years later. Okay, next slide, please. So this is our team. This is where it is. And we can share the slides later. And you can find me on here. And next slide, please. Right, this is my contact. Thank you for coming. As I hope you guys will not fall asleep by then. And next slide, please. We want you. Yeah. And yeah, this is our week because we are a bunch of entrepreneurs and crazy people. So if you don't know anything about this, do try it. Do come approach me. I might give you Bitcoin. Yeah. But I won't say how much because a lot of people come saying, hey, you give me Bitcoin. I was like, yeah. But I just want you to try because I used to be a Bitcoin trader, and after that I believed in it, I mined it, and after that it's changed my life. And anyone got a BTCC? Yeah, okay. I think you guys are hardcore ones. So let me tell you a story. Somewhere in a year ago, there was a Bitcoin association, Hong Kong Association conference. I spent my 10 years in Hong Kong. So I spent 2 startups in Hong Kong as well. So one of my friends brought me and said, hey, you know, we have part of the party. You know, has anyone go to conference? Can you want to go to conference with them? Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So, you know, that's cool, after party, you know, stuff like this. Technasia is one. It's coming up very quickly. I'll be going. Okay, you can catch me down there. I'll give you Bitcoin if you're going. But don't say how much is there. I won't disclose it. Okay, so I met Bobby Ho, the founder of BTCC. If you don't know who is BTCC, you can Google it. Just type BTCC. It's the largest exchange in the world. It's about 20%. 20-30%, and make a guess. On that time, I just went to the website, and it says that they're able to mine bitcoins. Guess how much? 1,000 bitcoins per day. Whew, that's a lot of money. And today's money, maybe 1,000. What's the price again? Yeah. So I think they have doubled down.
they have doubled down 2,000 bitcoins around. They can mine 2,000 bitcoins a day through their farms. And I was like, hey, who is this guy? It was like, you know, after that, he went to TechCrunch. And really, when the TechCrunch and speak about it, it just changed my life. It just changed my life. And I saw a physical IoT device, like small like this. And it was not even wallet exists, right? And this Malaysian guy was building an IoT Bitcoin device, and it's just like, it's so, I tried to send to you, you know, do you have a Bitcoin address? I was like, no. Okay, Bitcoin address. I tried to send to other ones. Okay. Then after that, it's trying to send to yourself, and it shows how it works. I was like, oh, this, there's no centralized control again. Then, so I wish he can send me one Bitcoin. Probably I'm like, anyway, I hope you can try this. This is amazing. You just do a QR code scan and yep.
You click the mall.
Yep, sorry about that.
You see that?
Yeah, just use internet as well. Yeah, we have either one. Okay, questions? Yeah, I'm done. Sorry about that. This is a bit long day. Yeah. And too long, yeah. That time was too long. Time of translation was about, it's quite fast, it's over 3G network. Yeah. Around that. Yeah. Any questions? Sorry about it. I'm very nope.
How
far
is your device?
Yeah, let's go back to the slides again. The car model and the which slides again?
So
back
again.
This one?
Yeah,
this
one?
Forward. No, this is back. This is forward. Forward.
That's right.
Yeah,
that's so a city might say, well, I don't understand blockchain, why don't you just take off?
I wish they can put Dropbox, but enterprise, you know, they don't. And everything is, they like to park themselves within inside. They want secure.
So, but then why would they do that? Why would the enterprise not that?
Yeah, and they're quite, because competitors, if I open up, competitors can see each other. Oh, you're doing this. I was like, okay, I tried to buy this and that. And that's why Bitcoin is my digital transfer. If you don't know, it's just transferring by your own amount. Yeah. So, competitors. Yeah, no, they can't see that.